You can hardly tell by looking at her, but in the last year, Marie Campe-Pierre-Louis learned how to walk all over again. Ask what happened to her leg, and the answer is simple. January 12th. Like it did with so many others, that day changed Marie's life forever. Haiti's earthquake 1 year ago created an estimated 2,000 amputees.
Every single one of these represents a person.
This is just a small percentage of the number of people in Haiti that have limb loss.
Healing Hands for Haiti and Handicap International are working to give them back their limbs and their lives. Their facility in Port-au-Prince offers every service new amputees need for free, providing consultations, measuring for the prosthetic.
People will come in, sit right here.
Manufacturing them on site.
Strong but inexpensive plastic.
And teaching patients how to use them. Marie has gotten very comfortable with her new leg.
Started to be okay.
It's the first step in rebuilding her life. Marie lost her home, grocery business, and her husband in the earthquake. Now living in a tent with her two young children. Being disabled doesn't bother me, she says. I have two hands and I only lost one leg and I have the prosthetic. The only problem that I have is taking care of my kids. Since January 12th, it's been a year of troubles. It's been a tough year for lots of people, even the littlest ones. Three-year-old Claudia Romain lost her mother in the earthquake and her leg, just as she was learning to walk 1 year ago. Now the center teaches her how to take those first steps and accept her disability. This doll is an amputee, just like her. It's an important part of the process. In Haiti, the disabled are often shunned. At the center, patients realize they're not alone. I teach them that life is not over, she says. If they have a mind and their body is still there, they're still living. Still living and learning to appreciate the small victories, like kicking a ball or climbing stairs.
Their faith, you know, brings them through a lot of difficult situations.
Sometimes I think about it, and after that I say, everything's up to God. Small steps towards acceptance of life's new reality. For thegrio.com, Maris Guiabocampo, NBC News, Port-au-Prince.